American Invitational Mathematical Examination or AIME. So from 2014 AIME, we have its problem 4th from set 2nd. And I never saw this kind of problem anywhere in any kind of mathematical Olympiad. So this problem says if 0.AB bar and 0.ABC bar are two decimal numbers such that 0.AB bar plus 0.ABC bar is equals to 33 divided by 37, then we need to find A, B and C, and not necessarily A, B, C are distinct. So first you please give your trial to this question and keep watching for the solution. Now one thing that we need to learn is converting the terminating and repeating decimals into fractional form. So if we have a number A which is equals to 0.x bar, so we know that we are able to convert that in the form of P by Q. It means it can be in the fractional form. So now for this, we multiply both sides by 10. So we have 10A is equals to 0.x bar times 10. So we have 10A is equals to x dot xxs. So we have 10A is equals to x plus 0.xx bar, and we know that x goes up to infinity, so we can say this thing is equals to this thing, which is A. So we have 9A is equals to x, so finally we have A is equals to x by 9, which is in our form of P by Q. Now we use this same thing for converting a double repeating number just by multiplying both sides by 100. So we have got A is equals to xy divided by 99 is the same thing as P by Q. And for triple repeating numbers, we just multiply both sides by 1000. Now we have given this, which is 0.AB bar plus 0.ABC bar is equal to 33 divided by 37. Now let x is equal to 0.AB bar, so this is equal to AB divided by 99. Similarly, let y is equal to 0.ABC bar, so this is equal to ABC divided by 999. Now adding these both equations, so we have 0.AB bar plus 0.ABC bar is equal to AB divided by 99 plus ABC divided by 999. And we have given the value of terms that we are adding, which is equal to 33 divided by 37. So we place that. So we take the common denominator. So finally we have this. Now cancelling some terms to make our calculation simpler, we have this, which is 9801 is equal to 111 AB plus 111 times ABC. And we know that A, B, C are digits only. Therefore, the range of A, B, C will always are natural numbers, which are lines between 0 and 9, including 0 and 9 both. So these A, B and A, B, C's are numbers. We are not multiplying them. They are numbers. So using this range and using this equation, we can easily find the value of A, B and C. Now we need to focus on this part, which is 111 multiplied by A, B. So first we multiply B with all ones. So we have B, B and B, and now we multiply A with all these ones. So we have A, A and A, and we are adding this with our previous term just by placing one unit left from the previous term. Now focus on this part. This is just the multiplication of ABC with 11. So first we multiply one with A, B and C. So we have ABC, and then we multiply another one with ABC, and adding this just left from one unit from our previous number. So we have got this. Now basically, according to our equation, we are adding these both terms, and after adding them, we have got this, which is 9801. So this thing is equals to 9801. So if we look at this part, we have b plus c is equals to 1, or this b equal to 11, because maybe the 1 of 11 undergoes the next term for the carry. But if b plus c is equals to 22, so averagely b and c both have to be equal to 11, and this is not possible because our range of a, b, c are just between 0 and 9, and 11 is greater than 9. So considering b plus c is equals to 22 is wrong. So b plus c is either 1 or 11. Now we look at our next part. So if we consider b plus c is equals to 1, then we have no carry. So simply b plus a plus b plus c is equals to some digit that undergoes in carry and 0. So b plus c is 1, so we have b plus a is equals to some digit with 0 minus 1. So if this sum digit be 0, then b plus a is minus 1, and that's not possible. Similarly, if that digit will be 1, then b plus a is 9, and that's possible. So if b plus a is equals to 20 minus 1, then we have b plus a is 19, and so averagely for getting 19, a, b both have to be equal to 9.5, and that is greater than 9, so this is also not possible. So we have only one value of b plus a if we consider b plus c is equals to 1, which is 9. So now we consider b plus c is equals to 11, so we have one carry on the next term. So we have b plus a plus b plus c plus 1 is equals to some digit with 0. So we have b plus c is 11. So finally we have b plus a is some digit with 0 minus 12. So if we consider this some digit be 10, then our b plus a goes negative, and this is not possible. So we need to consider b plus a is equals to 20 minus 12, which is equals to 8, and yeah, that's possible. So if we undergo with b plus a is equals to 30 minus 12, then we have b plus a is 9. And this thing is same as this, so we can don't write that. Now we look at in our next term in the addition. So we have this. Now if we consider b plus c is equals to 1, then we have one carry on that. So we have a plus b plus a plus b plus 1 is equals to some digit with 8, because maybe this some digit will be goes under the carry on next term. So we have consider a plus b is equals to 9. So we have 19 is equals to some digit with 8, and unit digits are not looking similar. So we can say these two things are not equal, and that's not possible. So it means considering b plus c is 1 goes b plus a 9 goes to this. So it means considering b plus c is 1 is completely wrong. Now we look for b plus c equal to 11, which gives us b plus a is equals to 8. So if we do that, we have got b plus a plus b plus a plus 2, because in that case b plus a plus b plus c is equals to 20, so we have 2 as carry, that will be equal to some digit with 8. So we can find b plus a is 8, so we have 18 is equals to some digit with 8. Now unit digits are similar, so this condition is completely correct. So it means yet considering b plus c is 11, we have got everything correct. Now we move forward to our next term, which is a plus a plus 1 as carry, which is equals to 9. So we have a is equals to 4, and a is equals to 4 is also possible because that lies between 0 and 9, and this is also a natural number. So we have got a is equals to 4. So finally, using the value of a, we can find b is also equals to 4 and c is equals to 7. So we have find A is equals to 4, B is equals to 4, and C is equals to 7. Now, once we verify that these all values are correct or not, so we have given this. So if we put the values, then 0.AB bar is equals to 0.44 bar, which is equals to 4 divided by 9. Similarly, 0.ABC bar is equals to 0.447 bar, which is equals to 447 divided by 999. So if we add these both values, then we have got something like this. And this thing is equals to 33 divided by 7 that we have given. It means the all values of ABC are correct. And that's our final answer. So now it's time for the rating of the problem. So for creativity, I want to give this problem 7 points out of 10. And for mathematical thinking, I want to give this problem 4 points out of 10. And for focus needed, I want to give this problem 4 points out of 10. So the average hardness of this problem is 5.